Compass Multijet 140 Limited 2017 review. The new Jeep Compass enters an ultra-competitive market. It'll need to be an improvement on the previous Compass if the compact SUV is to compete with the Volkswagen Tiguan and Citka. What is it? The Jeep Compass is the brand's new entrant, or re-entrant, in the most competitive SUV category of all, the compact crossover segment. Despite its SUV-heavy heritage, the brand hasn't had a rival to the likes of the Nissan Qashqai, Volkswagen Tiguan and Citka since 2015, when the last Compass was quietly withdrawn from sale. Jeep has enjoyed recent success with the smaller Renegade, and hopes to sell more of its new entrant in a segment that is expected to account for 300,000 sales in 2017. The Compass is predicted to sell more than the 14,000 Renegade's units that were sold in 2016. The Compass is based on a slightly longer version of the platform that underpins the Renegade, which also makes it a relative of the Fiat 500X. UK buyers have a bit longer to wait until they can get into the Compass, however. Although it first appeared in production form at the 2016 Los Angeles Motor Show, and then in European spec at Geneva in 2017, the Compass doesn't go on sale in the UK until January 2018. Because of this, we also have a little longer to wait for pricing and UK performance and economy stats, all of which are set to be confirmed in autumn of this year. As well as the standard, more road-oriented version that is expected to account for the majority of sales in the UK, Jeep is also offering the Trailhawk, a more hardcore version with higher ground clearance and more off-road tech. The standard version is likely to make up a greater proportion of sales, though, and comes with the mid-range diesel engine, all-wheel drive technology and a 9-speed automatic gearbox. What's it like? Although Jeep took a relatively daring step with the Renegade styling, it has played it much safer with the Compass. The trademark Jeep elements remain, such as the large, 7-slot front grille and a bespoke set of front and trapezoidal wheel arches. There are fewer in the way of striking features to grab the eye, although it looks smart, with the contrast color roof a particular highlight. Inside, the dash is dominated by the new Uconnect infotainment system, which features an 8.4-inch touchscreen. Lesser models come with a 5.0-inch or 7.0-inch version that controls the navigation, entertainment and other in-cabin heating systems. It is a bit fiddly to use, mainly because most things are operated by touchscreen alone, although a large volume dial and manual air conditioning controls below are welcome additions, even if it does mean a large number of buttons to navigate. The seats are comfortable and supportive, and offer a wide range of adjustment, and there's a good visibility from the driver's seat. A reversing camera and all-round parking sensors are available, but the latter are very quick to intervene, which makes the Compass a noisy drive through tight urban areas. The space in the back is a mixed bag. Shoulder room is good, and visibility is decent, but the panoramic sunroof severely cuts into headroom for adults, which means you'll end up slouching into what is a generous amount of legroom. The boot comes with a good amount of room, too, with a floor that can be set on 3 levels. Drop it all the way down and you get 438 liters of space, better than the Qashqai's 430 liter boot but short of the Volkswagen Tiguan's 615 liters. It's not perfect, removing the parcel shelf is a complicated affair and the seats can only be dropped from the side doors. Jeep is keen to stress the Compass's off-road ability, and the car dealt admirably with the limited off-roading we subjected it to, but the firm recognizes that it will spend most of its time on the road, and this is where it is a bit compromised. The 138 bhp engine pulls well, but is noisy and harsh under hard acceleration in a way that rivals aren't. The 9-speed automatic gearbox isn't as smooth as you'd hope, either. It changes down with a noticeable clunk that you would associate with a box with far fewer cogs. The steering is also very light, that's good at low speeds, but less reassuring on the motorway. Add some wallowing body roll around corners and the compass isn't as composed on the road as the likes of the Sitka. It does mean that it settles down to a comfortable cruise on the motorway, even if harsh potholes will send a jolt through the cabin at lower speeds.